Welcome back. In this video, we are going to simulate nitrogen rejection using cryogenic distillation. So this is our flow sheet in which the natural gas is first compressed and pre-cooled with multiple heat exchangers. Then the gas pressure drops using a valve, and from the flash vessel, the liquid and the vapors removed. The liquid recovered from the flash vessel is further cooled and recycled at the top of the distillation column, while the liquid from the flash vessel goes to the distillation column after further cooling and pressure drop. The vapors recovered from the distillation column mainly contain nitrogen that will exchange the heat from the incoming fluids and leave from the stream S4, while the liquid recovering from the bottom of the column mainly contain natural gas that will be pumped back to the sealed gas after exchanging heat with multiple heat exchangers. So start a blank simulation and add foundling components. Package Bang Robinson and go to the simulation. Install a stream, name it natural gas. I will use three nomenclatures over here. First is NG, that will be used for natural gas. Second is with the R, that will be used for the recycled stream. And the third is S, starting with the S, that will be stream that will carry nitrogen to the purging. So first is NG, the inlet stream has a pressure of 25 and flow of 3000 pound mole per hour. The stream is saturated vapors. The molar composition of the stream is 0.5. Stream don't have any water or carbon dioxide to avoid solid formation during the cryogenic process. The stream will first compress in a compressor. Till the pressure of 375. The compressed stream has a high temperature. The temperature is first reduced using a cooler. Cooler has a pressure drop of 0 and outlet temperature is 110. Some amount of gas is condensed. However, before flashing, the gas will pass through LNG exchanger. From the type hot, the pressure drop is 5 and its outlet temperature will be -200 Fahrenheit. After the LNG exchanger, we have a valve. The pressure will be reduced slightly over here. Now a separator in which the liquid and vapor will be separated. Now the top stream will be follow the nomenclature of R, while the bottom will be same as NG. We don't have any pressure drop in the separator. Now this top stream will further reduce its temperature and liquefy it and enter in the top of the column. First we have a cooler. Which has a zero pressure drop. And outlet temperature is -220. The steam start to liquefy. Now we have a recycle over here because the part of the stream will be recycled back into flash separator. After recycle, we have a splitter. That will split the incoming stream, and the outlet stream will again pass through a shell and tube heat exchanger, and at the end we have a valve over here. So the input recycle is R2, then we have R3. The splitter will split this R3 stream in two equal streams. This R4 stream will recycle back into flash vessel. R5 stream will pass through the shell and tube heat exchanger from the tube side. Keep the pressure drop zero and its outlet temperature will be -230. The valve will reduce its pressure up to 10 psi. Now this stream will enter at the top of the distillation column. The liquid feed of the distillation column will come from this NG5 stream, which will first go into LNG exchanger, again in the hot side, with pressure drop of 5 and outlet temperature -220. After the LNG exchanger, a valve will drop the pressure of the feed till the operating pressure of distillation column, which is 10 psi. Now we have a distillation column with the reboiler at the bottom. We have two feeds. The top feed is the recycle stream R7, while second is NG7. Total stage is 30, while the feed will enter at the 10th stage. The bottom pressure is 10 psi, while top is 7. Leave other blank. I will input the specification in the monitor section. You need to define one parameter to make the degree of freedom 0. Instead of defining the overhead flow rate, I will define the column temperature. In the column temperature, I am going to define the reboiler temperature, which will be -240. Before activating the specification, make sure your solver method in the parameter tab is modified. Now activate the simulation and specification. Our column has been converted. In the composition section, you can see the composition of S1 stream, which is mainly contain nitrogen, while the nitrogen in the natural gas stream is reduced drastically. Now the S1 stream will exchange its heat from the recycled stream. And again, the S2 stream will pass through the LNG exchanger. With the pressure drop of 3, and after that it will pass through the first LNG exchanger. With the same pressure drop. Now this NG8 stream will be pumped. Till 50. And then pass through the LNG exchanger 2. It's a cold stream, then need to be heated, and its outlet temperature is -224. Now again the NG10 will pass through the first LNG exchanger. A pressure drop of 5, and again it is a cold stream which outlet temperature is 100 Fahrenheit for S4. So our flow sheet has been completed.